Hello guys, welcome back to my channel, and if this is your first time here, you're most welcome. Please click on that red subscribe button down below and please click on the bell as well for notification. Thank you so much. So in the last update about Jodah and Akbar, Salim collected gongros from Anarkali, and on getting to the palace, Jalal realized that Salim is more interested in music instrument than sword. So Jalal wisely used a method to tell Salim that sword is more important to the king than musical instrument. That was the last update. Let's continue from there. Hamida says to Jodah that Jodah's husband and her son is unique because he finds a weird way to make other people understand things, and Jodah smiles. Hamida says that Jalal setting up a sword fight and music just to make Salim understand that sword is more important to a king is amazing. All the kids were learning Urdu and the priest was teaching them, and later the class ends. One of the kids says that Jalal showed a marvelous act, and Ada, that is Adam's son, says that he can do what Jalal did as well. Salim remembered how Jodah asked him to give back the gongros to the owner, and Salim goes to the soldier and says that he wants to go out of the palace. The soldier says that he cannot let Salim go out of the palace because Jalal has ordered them not to allow Salim out of the palace. Murad says to Salim that nobody should be able to stop Salim because Salim is the heir to the throne, so Salim should tell him where he is going to. Salim shows the gongros to Murad and says that he wants to return the gongro to its owner because his mother asked him to do so. One kid says that the soldiers will not let them go out, and he thinks that they should give the gongro to someone and the person will give it to its owner. Salim says that he doesn't even know the name of the girl who owns the gongro, so how will he describe the girl to anyone? Ada says that if they cannot go out openly, then they can secretly go. Salim says no. If Jalal gets to know that they sneak out of the palace, then Jalal would become very angry. Murad says that the problem is that Salim is always going for the right thing, but nobody would know that Salim has gone out. Salim says that he cannot go out alone, and Ada says that Kutub and Daniya will go with Salim. Kutub says me? No, because Jalal would not like it, and Ada says that nothing would happen. Salim asks that how then will he go out because nobody wants to go with him. Ada says that he have one idea, and Ada goes to the workers who were busy with the construction of the palace work, and Ada says children with them. Ada called the children and says that Salim has called them all to give them gift, and all the kids were glad and they goes with Ada. Ada tied all the children and he took their common man clothes from the children, and Salim wears the common man clothes so that nobody would recognize him. And Salim asks that what if he gets caught. Murad says that nobody would recognize Salim, and Murad puts sand on Salim's face. Ada says that Salim should not worry because they would undo everything in the palace, and Salim goes out with Kutub and Daniel. Ada and Murad were happy that now Jalal will get angry on Salim. Ada says that Salim will get 4 slaps, and 1 slap from Jodah, 1 from Jalal, 1 from Rukaya, and to round it up, another 1 again from Jodah. And both Murad and Ada laughs. Salim goes out of the palace with the working labors, and he was afraid, but he was able to pass the gate of the palace with Kutub and Dania. Jodah comes to Jalal and says that Salim is missing, and Jalal says that Salim must be around. Jodah says no, Salim is not in the palace, and Jalal says that where can he be, and he would ask the soldiers. Jalal was with Rahim, and Rahim called Murad and Ada. Jalal asks Murad and Ada if they see Salim, and Ada says no, they did not see Salim for a while now, and Jalal says okay and he leaves. Jalal asks the soldiers on the gate, and the soldier says no, Salim did not pass the gate of the palace, and Jalal says that where can Salim be, so he have to find everywhere. Salim was in the market with Kutub and Daniel, and Salim says that he knows that Jodah must be worried in the palace for him, but it was also Jodah who asked him to return the gongro, so they will return it. Jalal was with Mahan and Rahim, and Jalal asked Mahan to find the children as soon as possible. In the market, Kutub says that he is tired, and Salim says that it is just a little more work. Salim comes to the place where he saw Anarkali that day, and Salim says to Kutub and Daniel that he will come back after returning the gongro, and Salim goes in while Kutub and Daniel stayed outside. Salima says to Hamida that where can the children go to, and she is worried. Hamida says that they need to have faith that the children will come back to the palace soon. Jodah prays to Kana and says that Kana should protect her child, and Kana should please make Salim return to her. Rukaya comes there and says that Jodah should not worry, and Salim must be fine, and Jalal has gone to find him. Salim comes to the dancing center and asks for the girl who owns the gungros, but one man in the dancing center says that the girl has gone home because the class was over. Salim comes out and says that the girl has gone, and Kutub stops one man and says that does the man know the girl who comes there to dance. The man scolds the children and says that they are so small and they are stalking girls. Dania says that the man should shut up, and does the man not have the manners to talk to Prince? The man says Prince, and the man asks if the children did not look at their faces because they look like beggars, and the man goes from there. Salim along with Dania and Kutub were looking for the girl in the market, and Salim finally finds Anakali buying bananas, and Salim goes to talk to her. Salim comes to Anakali and shakes the gungro, and Anakali looks back. Salim shows Anakali the gungros, and Anakali says that why is Salim there? Salim says that he came to return the gungro, but Anakali says that she doesn't take things back. Salim says that his mother asked him to return the gungros, and he came to see Anakali with much difficulty, and the gungros are not even useful to him, so Anakali should take it. Anakali says that she doesn't need it anymore because they are old, and it is good that Salim took it from her because her mother has brought the new one for her, so Salim should keep it. Salim says that Anakali doesn't have manners to talk, and he is Jalal's son, so how can Anakali talk to him like that? Anakali says that Salim is the king's son but not the king, so when Salim becomes the king, then Salim should come to her and she will give Salim respect then. Salim puts the gungros in Anakali's hand and says that Anakali should do whatever she wants because he doesn't want to talk to Anakali. Salim comes to Kutub and Daniel, and Kutub says that why was Anakali scolding Salim? Salim says that Anakali is a mad girl, but they should go from there, and they leave. Salim, Daniel, and Kutub comes outside the palace, and they hide behind the bushes and sees the soldiers going out of the palace to look for them. In the palace, Jalal says that the children has gone out of the palace, so he would go and find them by himself. Outside the palace, Kutub says that he is hungry, and Salim says that he is worried about what his father will do to them if he finds out that they sneaked out of the palace. Jalal comes outside the palace and finds the children standing there, and Jalal angrily looks at Salim, and Salim and the other children started crying. Jalal brings Salim into his room, and Jalal sits with him. Jalal was angry, and he says that does Salim have any idea of what he has done, because Salim is the heir to the throne, and Salim will be the king, and Salim doesn't know how many enemies he have, and if the enemies got to know that Salim was out of the palace, then anything could have happened. Salim says that he went to return the gungros, and Jalal says that Salim would not go out of the palace from now on without telling anyone. Jodha comes there and says that Salim doesn't understand anything, because how can Salim go out of the palace without informing anyone? Jalal says that he has talked to Salim and he would not do that again. Jodha says that it is all because of Jalal, and it was Jalal's love that spoiled Salim, and Salim should get the punishment for what he did. Jalal says that Salim made a mistake and he has forgiven him because he knows that Salim will not do anything like that from now on. Jodha says no, Salim will get punishment because what if anything has happened to him? Jalal says that who can even look at the king's child? Jodha says that there are many enemies around, and Jalal says that what kind of a father will he be if he cannot protect his child? Jodha says that it was Jalal who made Salim stubborn, and Jalal says that he was just making Salim understand things and Jodha should ask Salim. Jalal and Jodha turn to talk to Salim after their argument, and they saw Salim who has already slept while they were busy arguing. Jalal and Jodha caress Salim's face, and Jalal says that it is true that Salim is like Jodha because Jodha also has the habit of going out of the palace in disguise. Jodha says that it is good that nothing happened, but she will still give Salim punishment. Jalal says that Jodha is already caressing him, and still Jodha wants to give him punishment. Jodha says that mothers are like that, because one moment they show love to their children, and the other moment they scold their children for doing what is wrong, and Jodha has tears in her eyes, and Jalal lovingly looks at Jodha. Alright guys, thank you so much for watching till the end, and please don't forget that we already have another channel. Please, if you haven't checked it out yet, please kindly check it out. The link will be in the description box below. Thank you all so much for your love and support, and I'll see you all again in my next video. Stay blessed and stay happy. Bye guys.